Everybody, are you ready for the very best news in the world? Everybody, are you ready? It's a gift for every boy and girl. Yeah, everybody all around the world. We know God loved us so much. He sent us His Son, we're singing.
Say Merry Christmas to you, and a big welcome to the Christmas Clubhouse. It's me, Manny, and I'm so happy to see you today. As you can see, we've been very busy decorating. We're having the best time. Look at this cool decoration that I found. Do you know what this is? That's right, it's a beautiful angel. Now I have to figure out where to put it. To find the perfect place. Oh. Wow, a basket. The note says, Merry Christmas from Miss Kathy Sue. My favorite, Miss Kathy Sue's Christmas cookies. Yummy. And even better, they're shaped like angels, just like my new angel decoration. I'm so excited. Hey, it's Ollie.
Hello, Manny. Decorating for Christmas, are you?
Hi, Ollie, I sure am. I was just looking at the Christmas cookies from Miss Kathy Sue. They shape like angels, just like my new angel decoration.
Those angel cookies are special. It's true. I have a story about another special angel for you. Just listen to this story. Just follow me through. Ho, ho.
Follow me through. Follow me through, ho. Oz got a Bible story for me and you.
Hi, everyone. I'm Aisha. Welcome to my cupcake food truck. I'm just getting it all decorated for Christmas. Have you started decorating at your house? Wonderful! I have some very special cupcakes to show you today. Are you ready? Ta-da! See, I have cupcakes with angel wings, and my good friend Miss Kathy Sue made these angel cookies today too. As you can see, we are all excited for Christmas, and angels have a big part in the story. If you're ready for the story, on the count of three, yell, tell me a story! One, two, three, tell me a story! Okay, so like I said, angels are a big part of the true story of Christmas. They came to announce the gift that God was giving everyone. Do you like to get gifts? Me too! Here's some special gifts now. Which would you rather have? A soccer ball or a scooter? That's great! Both are super fun gifts. Let's try another one. Which gift would you rather have? A train or a giant stuffed teddy bear? Great! Both are wonderful gifts. Now think about it. Why do we give gifts? Is it to show someone we love them? Yes! Well, God loves you and me so, so much that He gave us the most special gift. It all started long ago when God sent an angel to a girl named Mary. Whoa! Look! There's the angel! Mary was surprised and afraid. Everyone, show me you just saw an angel face. But the angel said, "Do not be afraid, Mary. God wants you to know that you're going to have a baby and you should call him Jesus. And he will be so special because here it comes. The reason why Jesus is so special. Drum roll, please. Jesus is so special because Jesus is God's son." When Mary heard this, she told the angel that she would do what God wanted her to do. And that is the beginning of the Christmas story. An angel told Mary that God was giving us a very special gift. His son, Jesus. Jesus is God's son. Did you like the story? If you did, give it two thumbs up. Two thumbs up. Oh, hey there, Ollie. Tell me, why is Jesus special?
Jesus is God's son. Yes, it's true. Now let's hear it from you. Tell me, why is Jesus special?
Jesus is God's son. That's the truth, friends. You better believe it. Now there's more to this story, so we'll see you next time. Bye!
So there's your story. It's all true. The angel visited Mary to tell her about baby Jesus. Ho!
Thanks, Ollie!
Goodbye to you. Ho! Ho!
Wow, what a great story. The angel told Mary that she was gonna have baby Jesus. I love hearing the true story of Christmas. I think I got the story. Did you get it? If you did, say got it. Get it?
Got it!
Good. You know what? Whenever I look at these angels, I'll think about the angel that told Mary that she was gonna have baby Jesus. I'll see you guys next time. Merry Christmas and bye.
God loved the world so much that he gave his only son, John 3:16. God loved the world so much that he gave his only son, John 3:16.